Peak hours are perhaps the greatest torment of a driver's existence. According to statistics, commuters in congested cities lose up to 5 days every year. But, as you might expect, there's a machine that can help us with that problem. The Golden Gate Bridge Barrier Transfer Machine, commonly known as the Road Zipper, is a machine that transfers barriers from one bridge to another. It transports the concrete or steel lane dividers that will separate the two lanes of traffic. It will adjust the barriers ahead of rush hour to provide extra lanes to help alleviate congestion in the busy routes. It's an incredible feat, considering the whole movable barrier over the 1.7 mile long bridge is made up of 3,200 blocks, each weighing 1,500 pounds. That, my friends, is what we call a heavy-duty zipper. While traffic and Jersey barriers may make you feel safer on the road, anyone who has ever been in an accident knows how unpleasant it is to be hit by one. However, there is a more secure path to take. Take a look at the South Korean development ETI roller system. These rollers convert a large portion of the impact energy into rotational energy. The truck is redirected back onto the road rather than bursting through the barrier. Ethylene vinyl acetate, or EVA, is the material used to make the rollers durable and long-lasting. Everything in its design aids in propelling the vehicle forward, much as standard crash barriers do. So if you ever come face-to-face with these, just roll with it. Have you ever experienced satisfaction from the perfect tessellation of brick road paving? If so, the Tigerstone Road is the ideal machine for you. The Tigerstone is like a huge printer. It's a slow-moving, electric-powered paver that travels along the road, leaving behind a perfectly assembled brick track. Unlike traditional methods, which require workers to place each brick onto the road manually, this method saves time, effort, and back discomfort for everyone involved. When manned by just two people, this stone printer with a width of about 20 feet can lay just under 3,300 square feet of paving per day. However, if you have limited space, it can also be altered to print pave smaller roads. Several countries nationwide have proposed future bans on fossil-fueled powered automobiles. France, Norway, the United Kingdom, and even China are all planning to get from point A to point B without using a gas pedal. But how will this be accomplished? Electrion, a business specializing in wireless electric roads, has presented one possibility. This Israeli startup has a road design that can wirelessly power electric vehicles while driving, and it's already been utilized in projects in Tel Aviv and Sweden. This concept is implemented by embedding a narrow copper coil into asphalt roadways, connecting it to the electric grid, and synchronizing it with installable vehicle electronics. The car can gather power wirelessly while traveling because of a receiver under the chassis linked to Electrion's dynamic wireless power transfer system. In principle, this eliminates the need for large batteries, and the automobiles may be powered indefinitely if it only travels on these roads. The world appears to be obsessed with drones nowadays, which can be irritating. But there are great possible uses for drones that we'd never think of. Researchers from the University of Leeds have proposed filling potholes with drones equipped with 3D printing capabilities. In theory, the drones might scan potholes on a closed road to determine the orientation of the indentation. They can then use an associated extrusion machine to pour asphalt or tar into the hole in a specified pattern to give it a smooth surface. This appears to be very promising, and I sincerely hope the technology is everything it claims to be. Have you ever seen the vast, uninterrupted lines of concrete barricades that sometimes run alongside highway stretches? You may have pondered how they got there in the first place, given how lengthy and continuous they are. They're made on-site using a process known as slip forming, in which cement concrete is poured and molded by a continually moving machine. The Power Curber 7700 is the result of combining that technology with some more mechanical creativity. A telescoping frame allows the machine to straddle two metal grids in a triangle configuration, Once in place, a conveyor belt transports cement concrete to the shaping chamber, which is mechanically placed to the triangle metal frame. This equipment can weigh up to 80,000 pounds with the conveyor, rails, and straddling device. Putting down a ton of asphalt isn't always enough when it comes to building a road from scratch. Depending on the topography, you may need to consider soil erosion and apply techniques to keep your well-constructed road from disintegrating. Some construction businesses use geocells for this reason. These are made of geosynthetic materials meant to endure up to 5,080 pounds of pressure per foot while reinforcing the soil substrate. Geocells can assist in maintaining structural integrity no matter what kind of soil it is, because the cellular design and base component can be altered based on the application. It's very remarkable, and it just serves to demonstrate that everyone, including roads, can use a little help once in a while. Potholes are a road user's worst nightmare, capable of converting a perfectly regular road into a frustrating obstacle course. They're so despised that the Automobile Association of the United Kingdom joked in 2011 about how sick they were of their country's numerous potholes. So, the Superior Road Solution invented the Python 5000 pothole patcher to address this road problem. Unlike traditional pothole patching techniques, which necessitate a great deal of physical labor, the pothole patcher can fill and patch any hole while the operator is peacefully sitting in the machine's cabin. The 5-ton feeder behind the cabin has an exhaust circulation scheme that keeps heated asphalt hot, reaching roughly 300 degrees Fahrenheit. Superior Roads further claims that the Python 5000 is 3 times faster than a 3-person workforce performing the same task. When it comes to the lords of slip-forming machines, Gomaco is at the top of the list. Their massive machines give various forms of pavement and can also be tailored to accommodate even the most unfeasible projects. A Gomaco GP3 slip-form paver is designed to pave up to 30 feet broad floor coverings. It works by pouring a certain amount of concrete before the paver, then spreading, shaping, and compacting it to a specific height. Its overall output reached 1,969 feet per day. That's how you build a path to success. Putting up an asphalt road is normal construction work, but what machine can you use to resurface your driveway's asphalt? Prepare yourselves for the LeBoy 8500. This machine is part of a special line of asphalt paver conveyors that are among the most efficient on the market. Asphalt pavers use a conveyor belt to transport asphalt from a hopper to a heated auger. After that, the drill will place a precise amount of hot asphalt in front of the screed, a fancy term for a tool that smooths materials. It can load a lot of asphalt in one go because of its 7.5-ton hopper. So, if you want to build a road, this is the machine for you. We may not often recognize it, but certainly, roads are among the most complicated infrastructures that humans create. The techniques used to construct them are both inventive and intriguing to see. Please share your thoughts in the comment section below if any of these extraordinary road building technologies surprised you. Thank you for watching.